to Dellavedova trying again. Got it! Dellavedova with a fist pump. He's hit three triples there tonight.
Everything has changed. The attitude. Look at this man. Look what he's doing. You don't see this. You haven't seen it all game until he started doing it. Now everybody's energy level is picked up.
All right, Matthew Dellavedova, welcome to Brooklyn. What do you think of the Barclays Center?
It's pretty awesome. It's definitely different from, you know, all the other arenas we've played in so far.
I noticed you were the first one out here before any other members of the Cavaliers out here putting your shots up, doing your work. Is that your routine to get out here as early as possible and work on your game?
The rookies were all out here earliest, so... And then, you know, the older guys come in, so try to get dressed really quick and get as many shots up as we can.
You play behind like a guy like Kyrie Irving, who obviously we know is, you know, a legit superstar. What sort of things do you take from, you know, watching him play that you sort of adapt to your own game at the moment?
Well, I mean, yeah, he's an incredible player and, his handles are pretty amazing. What he can do with the ball while he's going full speed. But yeah, just, you know, getting the chance to guard him in practice has definitely helped me improve.
You're a rookie in the NBA, but you're not a rookie to sort of playing against top level guys. Your performance at the London Olympics earned you some pretty good reviews, you know, with the NBA guys and all that sort of stuff. How much did that help you make that transition from not only college and then international to the NBA?
Playing for Australia, obviously, there's nothing better than that, and I love doing that. But that learning experience at the Olympics and the year before, we had a tour to Spain and a test event in London, and I really learned a lot off Brett Brown. He taught me a lot and gave me a lot of opportunities, and especially with how to play the NBA game and what I needed to try to work on to try to get to this level. And then also, you know, what to expect during the draft process. So he's been really big for my career.
What about the other Australian guys? You know, obviously Paddy's another point guard, Bogues, Aaron Baines as well. Do you reach out to these guys and sort of say, you know, can you give me some help with, or not help, but advice on with the season? Because they're veterans now.
Yeah, I mean, we played Bogut a few days ago, and it was really good to catch up with him, and he's having a really good season. And then Paddy and Bainesy, when we played at the Spurs, they both had really good games, and they're, you know, playing a really vital role for the Spurs. And it's just good talking to them and, you know, just getting little tips and just, you know, seeing how they're going. And before, you know, I got here as well, like just what to expect and what, you know, you need to work on and be prepared for.
Let's talk, I just want to talk a little bit about the national team at the moment. You're going to be playing in the World Champs coming up next year, yeah?
Yeah, definitely. You know, that's the goal, and we want to try and win a medal. That's our goal, and it was good. You know, with Andre is the coach now. He's had, you know, a few years as assistant, and I think, you know, he's going to do a really good job, and I think we built a really good base, you know, this off-season with the series against New Zealand. We got all the guys back, and everyone, you know, really committed to it, so it was good.
How excited are you for the future of Australian basketball? Obviously, now we've got four guys in the NBA. Dante Exum has got a tremendous buzz around him for next year. Yeah. Every American journalist here seems to be asking me about Dante. Ben Simmons the year after. How excited are you for the future of Australian basketball?
I mean, I think, you know, there's a really bright future, you know, with Australian basketball, and, you know, we want to try to capitalize on that as a national team, but obviously with guys like Dante and Benny coming through, you know, you don't get talent like that very often coming through, so they got great futures ahead of them.
Have you spoken to Andre about that? Like, is he sort of giddy with excitement about the possibilities moving forward, especially with the World Champs and then obviously the 2016 Olympics?
Yeah, I mean, Dre's always got a good energy about him, and he's definitely excited for what's coming up.
All right, look, one last question, because I know you've got to go. Obviously, the team goal is to win an NBA championship. What's your personal goal for the rest of the season from here on out?
I just try to keep helping the team, you know, whatever way I can. You know, I've been playing more, probably like two guard or even the three, just trying to defend and, you know, get loose balls. So, you know, whatever the team needs me to do, you know, I'll do that, and just keep trying to improve every day.
Cool. Thank you very much. Appreciate it.
Thanks, mate.